In four decades of public life, Dame Quentin Bryce has worked hard to make Australia a better country. And our former Governor-General isn't slowing down. She's supporting research into childhood diseases, along with a very powerful group of Aussie women, including Marie Bashir, Roz Packer and Jeannie Pratt. She spoke to our very own Ita Buttrose.
I don't think we're doing as much as we could in our society to support the unique childbearing, child-rearing role of women. Too often, you know, the first thing that's said to a mother with a new baby now is, when are you going back to work? Yeah. We aren't valuing it as we should. And some women reported that they never got a minute to themselves away from their baby with somebody coming and, you know, taking care of the baby for a few hours.
Do more mothers need to speak out about this as well?
They do, but you know, we have to as grandmothers. I think we must not underestimate the power, the influence, also the responsibility we have as elders to be advocates for our young mothers.
Well, you've got 11 grandchildren, I only have 5.
But it's a bit competitive, grandmotherhood, isn't it?
You know, I don't think I'm going to get any more, so I'll just have to bow to your superior number.
Not now, not ever.
We are all alarmed by the statistics. They are shocking.
You're now chairing a council to further the recommendations you made in your report. Not now, not never. Putting an end to domestic violence.
Yeah. We have a very serious responsibility, all of us across our country, to grasp this opportunity we have to actually take action about domestic violence, to get on with putting all the recommendations, the talk, the research into action. And it's something for every one of us to be engaged in.
National figures say that 1 in 6 women in Australia experiences domestic violence, which is a horrific figure. Is gender inequality at the heart of domestic violence?
Yes, it is. We need to start with attitudes and culture.
Are we failing to raise sons who respect women?
We are. The word respect is right at the heart of this, about respectful relationships, about children growing up, understanding what that means.
I want to stray into what is, I'm told by your office, forbidden turf, but I want to stray there because people wonder why I didn't. There was something you did when you were the Governor-General that I greatly admired. You offered to resign because you felt there may be a perception of bias when it was quite clear your son-in-law, Bill Shorten, was going to become the leader of the opposition. I thought that was an enormous sacrifice that most mothers-in-law would not make if that had come to pass.
It's very important in that role to do the right thing, shall we say.
Well, you know,
to conduct yourself as well as you possibly can.
Your daughter Chloe, Mr. Shorten's wife, she certainly got your beauty. Does she have your DNA? I mean, if Mr. Shorten does get to the lodge as Prime Minister, does she have what it takes to go along with him?
Oh, I think she's got what it takes to do anything, really.
A mother's influence at work again?
And wonderful, wonderful grandchildren too.
You do love her and her wardrobe.
She's wise, she's smart, she's compassionate, she's done so much for women in this country and families. She's the best role model. I adore her.
Yeah.
I really do.